Hi everyone, I am Priya Lotlikar, first year PhD research scholar from the Department of Educational Technology, IIT Bombay. Today we are going to look at data visualization in Excel. The type of visualization of Excel chart you select for your analysis and reporting depends upon the type of data you want to analyze and report, and most importantly, what you want to do with the data. Some operations that you would want to do on your data would be visualize the data to make some sense out of it if it is a big data. Secondly, classify and categorize the data or understand the distribution of data, determine the patterns and trends in the data or find relationship within the data or detect the outliers. Here are some most popular charts which are used for data visualizations in Excel: pie chart, bar and column chart, grouped bar chart, line chart, scatter plot, stacked bar chart, histogram, and heat map. We will look into this in detail in coming session. First, pie chart. When to use pie chart? You use pie chart when you want to show 100% composition of your data. For example, look at this image to the left side. Over here, the composition of data is 100%, whereas in this image, the composition is 82%, so this is a wrong pie chart. Use pie chart when you have to show breakdown of data into at most 5 categories. That is, if you create the pie chart for more than 5, like 8 or 10 categories, then pie chart would look cluttered, as you can see in this image. Thirdly, arrange the pie slices in such a way that you look at it in clockwise direction, where the biggest pie comes first, followed by the next bigger slice, and so on. This facilitates the ease in the readability of the pie chart. Let's see how to construct a pie chart. Here I have the student data which shows me the participation of students in annual gathering of a school. I want to visualize this data using a pie chart. So for that, first I need to select the entire table, go to insert, under the chart section, I need to choose the pie option. When I click on this, there are various representations provided to me. Choose whichever you want. I'll choose the first one. So this is how the pie chart would look like. But currently, there are no data labels on the pie chart. So to add the data labels, click on the pie chart, right click and click on add data labels. So now this is a complete pie chart for a given particular table. Here every column of the table comprises one slice from the pie chart. As you can see, the female participation is represented by the red color and male participation is represented by blue color. One thing to remember with the data is that rows should be sorted by numerical column in descending order, so the slices will be in the size order. Next is bar chart. Now when to use bar chart? You use bar chart when the axis labels are too long to fit in the column chart. So a bar chart is basically arranged along the horizontal axis, that is the y-axis. Next you have the column chart. The column chart is basically used to compare the data series. Let's see how to construct a bar chart or a column chart for the same data. So, choose the entire table, under insert in the chart section, select the column. In this you have 2D representation as well as 3D. Let me choose the 2D representation. So this is how the column chart would look like. Now if I want to construct a bar chart, again select the entire table, insert, under charts I have the bar option. Choose the 2D representation. So this is how the bar chart for this table would look like. Here, each row will become a separate bar. So the rows should be sorted in numerical column in descending order. Next, we go to grouped bar chart. When to use it? You use it when you want to look how the second category variable changes within each level of the first. That is basically compare the totals and one part of the total. Let's see how to construct a grouped bar chart. I have this data on the student participation over a period of 4 years. So, in order to view this in a group bar chart, select the entire table. Go to Insert. Under Insert, choose the bar option. In this bar, you choose the 3D bar. So, this would give you the bar visualization. I can even choose the column representation. So, choose the entire table. Under Insert, in Chart section, Column, choose the 3D column. So, this is how the 3D bar and column representation looks like. Here, the color codings are provided for every group. So, you can distinguish between these groups. As you can see, the male and female participation over the years are being represented with two color codings. Next, we'll look at line chart. So, line chart are basically used when you want to focus or show data trends such as uptrend, downtrend, short-term trend, long-term trend, that is, changes over several months or years between the values of the data, as you can see in this image. Also, use line chart when order of categories is important. Like you can see in this, the order of categories of this respective product is important over here, rather than in a bar chart. Let's see how to construct line chart. This is the same data that we used to construct the group bar chart. So, basically this is a multiple group data. We can also use a line chart to represent this data. So, for that, select the entire table. Go to Insert, under Chart section, choose the Line option. You can choose any representation you want. Let me choose the first one. So, this is how the line representation for this particular data looks like. As you can see, the lines red and blue represents the trend in male and female participation. Next, we will look at scatter plot. So, scatter plot is basically used to analyze and report the relationship or the correlation between two variables. So, more the data points, better will be the scatter plot. You can see the independent variable is on the x-axis and dependent variable is on the y-axis. Let's see how to construct a scatter plot. Here I have the data which captures the height and weight of students from a class. Now since we have two variables, this is a bivariate data. So we use a scatter plot to basically compare or show relationship between the two variables. So let's develop a scatter plot to compare the weight and height of students in this class. For that, I need to choose the columns of the two variables. So choose these two columns. Go to Insert, under Chart section, choose a scatter plot. You have various representations over here. Let me choose the first one. If you go to see, this doesn't look like a clear representation of the data. The minimum value would lie somewhere 130 to 140 and maximum value would lie somewhere from 190 to 200. So let's modify the x-axis to get a clear picture of this data. For that, click on the x-axis, right click, format axis. So over here in the axis option, set the minimum value to 140 and maximum value to 190 and say close. As you can see, this gives a clear picture. Same thing we can do with respect to y-axis. So click on the y-axis, right click, format axis. So I can set the axis minimum value to somewhere 40, as you can see in the image, and maximum value to somewhere 80. Close. So now this gives us a clear picture of the entire data. If you want, you can even add a trend line to give a more clear picture about this data. So for that, I can choose the data points, right click and click on add trend line. In this, the trend line that is added is a linear. Close. So this gives us a clear picture of a linear increase in the trend of the height and weight. That is, height and weight are linearly proportionate to each other. Next, we'll look at stacked bar chart. So you use stacked bar chart when you want to compare the numeric values between the levels of the categorical variable. That is, each bar indicates a numerical value. So when you want the relative decomposition of each primary bar based on the levels of the second categorical variable, we use a stacked bar chart. That is, the order of the bar is from the largest to the smallest. Let's see how to construct a stacked bar plot. I have this data over here which gives me the number of employees required on a particular project for these respective months. And the number of employees are being categorized into programmer, web designer, graphic designer and QA engineer. So in order to have this stacked look of these employees every month, I need to construct a stacked bar plot. So for that, I need to choose the entire table. Go to Insert, under Chart section, choose the bar plot. In bar plot, I need to use the stacked bar. So this is how the stacked bar plot would look like. If you want, you can even have a column representation of this. So for that, choose the entire table. Insert, under charts, go to columns. You can even choose the 3D visualization of the stack. So when I click on this, so this is how the 3D visualization of the entire data looks like. So every category of the programmers, that is programmer, web designer and graphic designer and QA engineer, are being color coded. So you can see in January, the total number of employees were required were 5. And so on. Next, we will look at histogram. You use histogram when you want to show the frequency of the distribution for quantitative data. In order to create histogram, you need to install the analysis tool pack. Let's see how to construct a histogram. You need to install the analysis tool pack. For that, go to files, under options, click on add-ins. Choose the analysis tool pack, click on go, checkbox of analysis tool pack should be checked and say ok. Once this is done, go to data and you will see data analysis over here under analysis category. Now histogram gives you the frequency distribution of the data within particular ranges, that is called bin. I have this data over here, that is the test score of students from a class. And this is the bin range that I have set, that is 60 to 100. So this would be 0 to 60, 60 to 65, 65 to 70 and so on. So to construct the histogram on this data, click on data analysis in the data section. Choose the histogram option and say OK. Now I need to choose the input range, the bin range. For the histogram, input range will be the test score column. So for that, choose the entire column. In the bin range, choose the bin column. Don't forget to check the labels because we have also included the test score in the data. Now since we want the output in the same Excel, choose the output range and give the reference address. Don't forget to check the chart output since we also want the histogram chart. Now this is how the histogram looks like. Let me modify it a bit by expanding it. So the values on the x-axis are a bit misleading. So let me modify these values. 60 would be 0 to 60, this would be 60.01 to 65, then 65.01 to 70 and 95.01 to 100. There you go. This gives a better clear picture. I can even change the name of the x-axis variable. So this, let me write it as test score. If you go to see, histogram basically gives a continuous distribution of the data without any gaps. So now since these gaps are over here, let me modify this chart a bit. Click on the bars, right click, choose the format data series. Under series option, you have the gap width option over here. Make the gap width to 0% and click on close. This is an appropriate histogram for the data. And the last one, heat map. Heat map is used to represent the individual values as colors. You can see the gradual change in the value strand in the data. For example, a heat map can be used to visualize the engagement of students in class using the Moodle learning logs. Let's see how to construct a heat map. So I have this data over here which has internet facilities on one side as a one variable, and second variable would be the email signups, the join site, reviews for these respective facilities. Now in order to construct the heat map for this, I need to select the numerical values only. So let me select the numerical values. Under home, go to conditional formatting, click on this and choose the color scales. In this, choose the first one. Let me format this table a bit. Right click, format cells. Border, I choose this border for color white. And I'll say OK. So this is how a heat map looks like. So the heat map will give you relationship between two variables, one plotted on each axis. So you get to see the change in the colors through the axis. You get to see the pattern in the change in trend of the two variables.